Hello students, in the last class we discussed about the allotropes of the sulfur. In this class we can discuss about the compounds of the sulfur. Among them very most important first compound is sulfur dioxide, that is SO2. First we consider the preparation of the sulfur dioxide. First method is by burning elemental sulfur. By burning sulfur in presence of excess of air forms the sulfur dioxide. This is the first method. By burning elemental sulfur in excess of air forms the sulfur dioxide. Second method is by roasting the iron pyrites, that is the sulfide ores in excess of air, we get the sulfur dioxide. By roasting iron pyrite formula is FeS2. Any sulfide ore, by roasting any sulfide ore, already we discussed in the metallurgy, by roasting the sulfide ore, for example iron pyrite, in excess of air we get the sulfur dioxide Fe2O3. We have to balance this reaction by using 4 FeS2 and 11 O2, 2 Fe2O3 and of 8 SO2. This is the second method. Third method is lab method. In the laboratory, sulfur dioxide is prepared by treating sulfide. Sulfide formula is SO32-. By treating sulfide with dilute sulfuric acid. By treating with dilute acid with sulfide, we get the sulfur dioxide. This is a laboratory method, most important one for the competitive level also. In the last KSET, that is 2020 KSET, they considered this preparation and continue the another question. In the same question, they are used two concepts. First preparation of the sulfur dioxide. Later, they can continue the another question. You have to remember the preparation by using sulfide. That is sulfide means SO32-. The acid, we know that acid means donate the proton. Because in our syllabus, they mention the ionic equation. Hence, we are using the H+. By treating sulfide with acid, we get sulfur dioxide liberating water. That is, to balance this reaction, 2H plus, then reaction get the balance. Or sodium hydrogen sulfide, NaHSO3, if you treat with an HCl, then you get sulfur dioxide, then NaCl plus H2O. If you read the ionic equation, this much is enough. If you use sodium hydrogen sulfide, then take HCl or H2SO4. If you take H2SO4, then you get Na2SO4. If you use HCl, then NaCl get removed. This is about the preparation. In addition to, in NCRT, they mentioned only this one. In addition to that one, if you treat copper with sulfuric acid, if copper is heated with sulfuric acid, then we get copper sulfate, sulfur dioxide liberating water. Copper also heated with the sulfuric acid, it is 2H2SO4, 2H2O. Then by using copper with sulfuric acid, we get the sulfur dioxide. Or by treating sulfur with the sulfuric acid, by treating sulfur with sulfuric acid, we get the sulfur dioxide liberating water. Sulfur dioxide liberating water. That is 3SO2, then 2H2O. This is about the preparation of the sulfur dioxide. Then you consider the properties of the sulfur dioxide. You consider the properties of the sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is a colorless gas. It is a colorless gas with pungent odor. Pungent odor. If you eat copper with sulfuric acid, you get the colorless gas with a pungent odor in the laboratory. That gas is a sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is a colorless with a pungent odor. It is soluble in water. That sulfur dioxide can be easily soluble in water. It is soluble in water. It is liquefied at room temperature. That can be liquefied at room temperature. This is about the physical properties. Then you consider the chemical properties. First one is that the sulfur dioxide reacts with water. Sulfur dioxide reacts with water. Forms the sulfurous acid H2SO3. H2SO3. This is called as the sulfurous acid. Sulfur dioxide when dissolved in water, it produces sulfurous, not sulfuric. This is a sulfurous acid. If you write SO4, H2SO4, that is sulfuric. SO3, then it is called sulfurous acid. This is the first one. Then second property is sulfur dioxide reacts with sodium hydroxide. Sulfur dioxide reacts with sodium hydroxide. Then you get the sodium sulfide. Sodium sulfide, Na2SO3 plus H2O. That formed sodium sulfide. Formed sodium sulfide further reacts with Na2SO3. Sodium sulfide further reacts with the excess of the sulfur dioxide. Excess of the sulfur dioxide, we get sodium hydrogen sulfide. Sodium hydrogen sulfide. You have to write the two steps also. Sulfur dioxide when reacts with NaOH, that is 2NaOH, you get Na2SO3 plus H2O. This is called sodium sulfite. Sodium sulfite. Sodium sulfite, formed sodium sulfite further reacts with excess of the sulfur dioxide. Then we get sodium hydrogen sulfide. Sodium hydrogen sulfide, that is sodium bisulfide. Sodium bisulfide. Sodium hydrogen sulfide. This is the second one. This is very most important one. You have to remember both the steps. Then third one is sulfur dioxide reacts with chlorine. Sulfur dioxide reacts with the chlorine in the presence of the charcoal. In the presence of the charcoal acts as the catalyst. Charcoal as the catalyst. Sulfur dioxide reacts with chlorine in the presence of the charcoal as the catalyst. Then we get the sulfuryl chloride, SO2Cl2. This is called sulfuryl chloride. This is important for one mark. To complete the equation, they can ask this question. Sulfuryl chloride. Then next one is sulfur dioxide oxidized, that is reacts with oxygen in the presence of the vanadium pentoxide catalase. Vanadium pentoxide catalase. Then it forms the sulfur trioxide. Sulfur trioxide. SO2 plus O2 gives 2SO3. This is used in the contact process for the manufacture of sulfuric acid. This is also important for the completing the equation. Then one more is sulfur dioxide. If acts as a reducing agent, sulfur dioxide acts as a reducing agent. The sulfur dioxide SO2 behaves as a reducing agent. Reducing agent. Why it behaves as a reducing agent means because it donates the nascent hydrogen in the presence of the moisture. Only in the presence of moisture, sulfur dioxide behaves as a reducing agent. That is, SO2 plus H2O, SO2 plus H2O, that gives nascent hydrogen and forms an H2SO4, H2SO4, that is 2H2O. Only in the presence of the moisture, it can donate the nascent hydrogen, hence sulfur dioxide behaves as a reducing agent. Among the reducing property, it reduces, sulfur dioxide reduces yellow colored ferric ion. Ferric means the Fe3+. Yellow colored ferric ion or ferric chloride. In our syllabus, they mention the ionic equation. In competitive, they can ask that ferric chloride. Yellow colored ferric ion into colorless ferrous ion. Ferrous means the Fe2+. Colorless ferrous ion, that is the ferrous chloride. Yellow ferric chloride is yellow color. Ferrous chloride is colorless. Sulfur dioxide reduces yellow colored ferric ion. That is, to consider the reaction SO2 in the presence of moisture only, it reduces ferric ion Fe3+ into colorless ferrous ion. Ferric ion, yellow colored ferric ion reduces to colorless ferrous ion. It is colorless. It is yellow. Sulfur dioxide is a reducing agent. It gets oxidized. SO2 oxidized to sulfate, sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid means the SO4-2-. It gets oxidized to sulfate, liberating H+. Because they are mentioned only ionic. In this equation, we are used with H2SO4. But here they considered the ferric ion, ionic form. Hence you split the sulfuric acid. If you use FeCl, then you write H2SO4. H2SO4. They are mentioned that ionic equation. Hence you split that sulfuric acid as SO4-2- and H+. To balance this reaction, 2H2O. 2H2O, 4H+. 4H+. This is the first one. It reduces yellow colored ferric ion into colorless ferrous ion. Then, second reducing property is it decolorize. That sulfur dioxide decolorizes acidified potassium permanganate. Acidified potassium permanganate, KMnO4, that permanganate color is purple. It decolorizes acidified potassium permanganate to colorless manganese sulfate, that is Mn2+ ion. Manganese means Mn2+ ion. This reaction is used for confirmatory test for the sulfur dioxide. Name the confirmatory test for sulfur dioxide means even you can consider yellow colored ferric ion into colorless ferrous ion. In commonly in the laboratory, we are using one is potassium permanganate, another one is also potassium dichromate paper. In our syllabus, they are considered the potassium permanganate. It decolorizes acidified potassium permanganate. Permanganate color is purple color to colorless manganese sulfate or manganese ion. Then for that one, you have to mention the reaction, that is an SO2, then H2O. H2O, permanganate means an MnO4- permanganate ion, MnO4- to form that Mn2+ and again SO4-2- sulfur dioxide oxidized to SO4-2- liberating the H+. Then you have to balance that reaction by using 2H2O, 2MnO4-, 2Mn2+, then 5SO2, 5SO4-2- and 4H+. This is the confirmatory test. And one more, in the laboratory we are using, this is not mentioned in our NCERT. In our NCERT, they mentioned only this is the confirmatory test. That is the acidified potassium permanganate, purple color changes into colorless manganese ion, Mn2+. In the laboratory, we are using a dichromate paper. That sulfur dioxide also decolorized. It also decolorized the acidified, it also decolorized that acidified potassium dichromate, K2Cr2O7. Acidified potassium dichromate. Dichromate color is orange. Orange color, dichromate paper, orange color to green color. Green color, chromium sulfate. Chromium sulfate, Cr3+. In the laboratory, generally in the salt analysis, we are using the sulfite radical, SO3. SO3 2-. To the SO3 2-, if you add the H+, then we get a sulfur dioxide. It is a colorless gas. To identify whether it is an SO2 or CO2, even in the first group acid radical, we are using carbonate acid radical. To the carbonate, if you add carbonate or sulfide, if you add dilute H2SO4, dilute HCl, you get sulfur dioxide or carbon dioxide. To identify whether sulfur dioxide or carbon dioxide, if you pass the colorless gas into lime water, lime water, if it turns to milky, indicates it is the carbon dioxide gas. If not turns to milky, then you consider a orange color dichromate paper. If it turns to green color, then the gas evolved is sulfur dioxide. To evolve the sulfur dioxide, then the radical must be the sulfide. This is important for the salt analysis. Hence, I have explained it here only. Then, this is helpful for the competitive exam. For that one, reaction is sulfur dioxide. Then, dichromate means Cr2O7 2-. Cr2O7 2-, H+, acidified dichromate. Then that forms Cr3+, SO4 2- plus H2O. In our previous reactions, we are using H2O to the reactant side. But in this case only, we have to consider H2O to the product side. To balance this one, 3SO2, 2H+, 2Cr3+, and 3SO4 2-. Here, dichromate color is a green color. Orange color. Dichromate is an orange color. It is orange color. To the sulfur dioxide, if you express an orange colored dichromate paper, then you get orange color dichromate turns into green color. Then indicates that it is the sulfur dioxide gas. This is also the confirmatory test for the sulfur dioxide. But NCERT, you only consider the potassium permanganate. Then you consider the harmful effects of the sulfur dioxide. That is harmful effects of the sulfur dioxide. That is, sulfur dioxide is a major air pollutant. They can explain either, or they can ask either how that sulfur dioxide harmful effects, or it acts as an air pollutant. Then first point is SO2, sulfur dioxide, it is an irritating gas. Because of its pungent odor, it is an irritating gas to the respiration. It causes throat and eye irritation. Which results in the tears. Which results in the tears and redness in the eyes. This is the first harmful effect. It is an irritating gas for the respiration. It causes throat and eye irritation, and causes that results in the tears and redness in the eyes. It is harmful, even it is harmful for the plants. How it is harmful for the plants means it slows down the formation of chlorophyll. It slows down the formation of chlorophyll, resulting in loss of green. loss of the green color in the leaves. This chlorophyll is responsible for green color of the leaves. Due to slow down it, that sulfur dioxide slow downs the formation of chlorophyll, hence automatically green leaves loses its green color. These are the harmful effects on the plants. Then SO2 reacts with water. SO2 reacts with water, that is with the rain water, generally with rain water, forms the sulfurous acid. Sulfurous acid causes an acid rain. Sulfur dioxide reacts with rain water, forms sulfurous acid, which mainly causes the acid rain. That acid rain damages the marbles of the building. Is about the harmful effect. Then structure of that SO2. If you consider the structure of SO2, that is structure of SO2 is S double bond O. Then here 2 lone pair, here 3 lone pairs, and sulfur contains 1 lone pair. Then resonating structure, that is S here single bond O, here double bond O. Here 2 lone pairs, here 3 lone pairs, and sulfur contains 1 lone pair. All sulfur oxygen bond, either single or double bond, that bond lengths are identical. Why that bond lengths are identical means due to that of resonance, all the sulfur oxygen bond lengths are identical bond length and are covalent in nature. This is about the structure. Then finally, uses of the sulfur dioxide. It is used for refining of petroleum and sugar, and mainly used as an bleaching agent. For bleaching of silk and wool. Then it is used as a bleaching agent. Already in the last class, I explained that bleaching action of ozone and chlorine is permanent, while that sulfur dioxide is temporary. That bleaching action of ozone is due to oxidation, while bleaching action of SO2 is due to that of a reduction only. It is temporary. Why it is temporary means, if you bleach that silk by using sulfur dioxide, after certain time that silk will regain its color, hence it is taken as a temporary. Then used as a disinfectant, SO2 used as a disinfectant and preservative. And in the manufacture of the sulfuric acid, or with sodium hydrogen sulfide, is about the some of the important uses. This bleaching action is very, very important for the competitive level. Bleaching action of SO2 is temporary, and that is mainly due to that of the reduction. In the next class, we can study about the sulfuric acid.